With bated breath, MPs waited for the arrival of the chairperson of the commission, Jean Mensah, after the meeting had been rescheduled from Thursday to Saturday. Before the EC chairperson took the rostrum, the speaker made a pronouncement on the request from the MPP to declare the Fomina seat vacant following the decision of the incumbent, Andrew Amankwa Esiama, to contest the 2020 polls as an independent candidate. The speaker delivered his ruling on the matter and referred same to the Electoral Commission.
How does an MP operate both as an elected independent MP and at the same time an MPP MP if he should win the election? This lacuna of a ridiculous situation is not what is anticipated under the 1992 Constitution. In the circumstances, Parliament has, it is determined that the conduct of Honourable Andrew Amankwa Esiama amounts to vacating his seat in Parliament. Accordingly, we bring this to the notice of the Electoral Commission for the necessary action to be taken in accordance with the law.
The chairperson of the commission addressed the House, beginning with a response to concerns about the seeming lack of respect for Parliament. Chairperson of the commission further touched on the state of preparedness for the election in terms of logistics, procurement and other related matters.
Mr. Speaker, the commission has created 38,622 polling stations across the country. This is some 5,000 polling stations more than the 2016 polling stations. I'm happy to note that the threshold for the polling stations is not more than 749 voters per polling stations. I wish to assure you and this August House that we are fully prepared and ready for the elections in December. And we are working with our teams to ensure that the elections are credible, they are fair, they are orderly, they are transparent and peaceful.
The leaders of the House had questions for the Commission in relation to manual verification of voters, integrity of the ballot printing process, and the procurement of indelible ink.
My first question is to ask whether manual verification will be tolerated on December 7th. My second is Zabzugo 435 by a court order, whether she accepts that the court indicted the Electoral Commission when the court in its ruling in the High Court stated that the District Electoral Review Committee, which ought to have been constituted by the Electoral Commission, was not properly constituted.
Of the biometric registration equipment and biometric verification equipment, even though these ones have been procured recently, are much more robust and, the Speaker, newer than the older ones. Is he in the position to tell us the savings that they've made? Speaker, second, the procurement of indelible is something that we have always had problems with. Can we know the source of these procurements?
In response, Jean Mensah defended the integrity of the processes underway for the election.
The question of the number of polling stations, and I did mention that we have 38,622 polling stations. The threshold has been set at 749. However, some 70% of these polling stations have a voter population of 500 or less, but the threshold is 749. It's important to emphasize that our register only contains unique individuals. I think the question was raised also about foreigners on the roll. I think to the best of our knowledge, with the help of the citizenry, we can confidently say that our register does not contain foreigners. If it comes to the attention of the commission that there are foreigners on there, I think the proper agencies would be noted and, you know, steps will be taken, and once it is proved that those persons are foreigners, we will take steps to ensure that they do not vote. With the issue of manual verification, we did mention, I think it was a point that I missed in my presentation, that to date, we do have on the register, please tell me, we have a total of 17,029,971 eligible unique voters on the register. Of this number, we have some 547 who we have put on the list we call the deficit. These are persons who registered, but for some reason have not been reflected in the register.